If I ask you, what is your favorite movie of all time? What do you think of? Some of you may think of this, or this, or this, or this, or this, or that, or this, or maybe even this. I don't know why, but hey, taste is subjective.
What, we some kind of Suicide Squad?
The point is, everyone has their own favorite movie. But what makes a movie your favorite movie? Your favorite movie of all time shouldn't mean something to you. It doesn't matter the quality of the movie, good or bad, it should make you feel something while watching it that makes you connect with the movie, the characters, the story, the scenarios, and the themes being presented. Your favorite movie is your favorite movie for a reason. And for me, I have never been more connected to a movie than Ferris Bueller's Day Off. Yeah, the high school teen comedy John Hughes classic from the 80s is my favorite movie of all time. But why? What makes this movie so special to me? Well, in order to explain that, we're gonna have to go back to 2011. I was in fourth grade, I think? And if you were to ask little Luquinha what was the one thing he hated the most in the world, he would say, school. This isn't really anything new. Kids hate being trapped in a classroom for 8 hours doing nothing but boring schoolwork. Kids want to go and play outside, or stay inside playing video games, or watch TV, and they would do anything to not go to school. And by anything, I mean they would pretend to be sick. Dude, sick days are the best. You could stay home, do whatever you want, eat whatever you want, and just relax. I'm guilty of it, and I know all you sons of bitches watching this are guilty of it too, so stop lying. I remember one day in fourth grade, I faked a stomach cramp and got to stay home, which was rad as hell, obviously. But later that night, my mom said we were gonna watch a movie, and she chose this movie I'd never heard of called Ferris Bueller's Day Off. It was soon after we finished the movie that I realized that my mom knew I faked my illness, but I didn't care because I fell in love with this movie. Now back then, I didn't know what made a good movie. I just remember loving it because it was funny. That's pretty much it. But looking back on it, being the smart, analytical, pretentious asshole that I am now, I know exactly why I love this movie and why it works so well for me. The idea of skipping school or work or any form of responsibility is something that anyone, not just kids, anyone can relate to. John Hughes manages to write a story that resonates with everyone and makes us want to skip whatever chore or responsibility we have and just have some fun. That's what this movie is about, seizing the day. Ferris sums up what the movie is about perfectly with the most iconic line from the movie.
Life moves pretty fast. You don't stop and look around once in a while, you could miss it.
We all get caught up in the mess of our lives so often that we forget to stop and take a moment and enjoy our life and not take it so seriously. And it's Ferris that reminds us to stop and look around once in a while. Oh, speaking of which...
4,000 restaurants in the downtown area. I picked the one my father goes to.
We're pinched for sure.
No way, Cameron. When the meat get pinched, the bolt survive. Let's go.
Let's surrender.
Never.
Ferris Bueller is the epitome of cool. Either we wish we were him, or we wish we had someone like him in our life. Although it's abundantly clear that Ferris will lie and cheat to get whatever he wants, it's also abundantly clear that he loves his friends and does what he does for them. Ferris is a static character, meaning he doesn't go through any significant changes or has an arc in the story. He has one goal in mind and one goal only. Have the best day ever with his friends, especially his best friend, Cameron Frye. Ferris, more than anything, is a catalyst for almost everything happening in this movie. He's the cause of the whole Save Ferris movement. He's the cause of Mr. Rooney losing his sanity. He's the cause of Jeannie ending up in a police station. He's the cause of the parade scene, which fucking rules, by the way. And he's the cause of Cameron's breakdown, but also clarity. Normally, in any other movie, this type of character just wouldn't work and couldn't work. But it's because of John Hughes' writing and Matthew Broderick's charisma that make him work. John Hughes himself said, "I wanted to do a film that showed someone for whom life is easy and that they aren't beset with problems. I really just wanted to do something that showed the positive values of not taking yourself quite so seriously. Our teen years are not going to be here forever, so why waste it? We need someone like Ferris to remind us to stop taking ourselves so seriously and just loosen up." Throughout the entire movie, Ferris is trying to tell this not only to us, but also to his best friend.
I'm so disappointed in Cameron. $20 says he's sitting in his car debating about whether or not he should go out.
Cameron Frye. Cameron Frye is the character who undergoes the most change in the film and has a full and complete arc. Cameron is just your average guy who stresses out too much, takes himself too seriously, and is too uptight, and doesn't know what he wants. In other words, Cameron represents our anxieties. He represents us. When we first meet Cameron, he is a lonely, depressed, and anxious kid with daddy issues. He can't stick up for himself, he has no confidence in himself, and he also most likely hates himself. In the scene where Ferris and the gang visit the Art Institute of Chicago, Cameron is sitting staring at the iconic painting, a Sunday afternoon on the island of La Grande Jatte. In the DVD commentary, Hughes said that Cameron looks at the little girl with her mother, and he sees their tender relationship, which is something he never had. And the deeper he looks into the eyes of the girl, the less he saw, because of the style of the painting. He sees himself in that little girl, and is afraid that the more you look into Cameron, the less you'd see. You'd see nothing. From the way that Cameron talks about his dad, it's clear that he's been neglected by him for most of his life. We hear from Cameron directly that his father pretty much despises everything, except for one thing. The Ferrari. The Ferrari is a visual reminder for how little Cameron means to his dad. Cameron constantly mentions how much the car means to his dad.
Ferris, what are you talking about?
Ooh.
Ferris, my father loves this car more than life itself.
Cameron is willing to do anything to keep the car safe and hoping that it'll make his dad happy, even though he knows that won't make a difference. However, Cameron finally comes to the realization that if he doesn't stand up to his dad, he'll live the rest of his life miserable.
I am not going to sit on my ass as the events that affect me unfold to determine the course of my life. I'm going to take a stand. I'm going to defend it. Right or wrong, I'm going to defend it.
So he dents the shit out of it. Cameron beating the shit out of his dad's Ferrari is the first time Cameron ever felt alive. For once, he does something that he wants to do, rather than doing something that someone else wants him to do. And it's all because of Ferris. Ferris is the one person in Cameron's life that has given him attention and compassion. We never even met Cameron's parents. We've only met the Buellers. And that just goes to show how distant Cameron's parents are. Ferris was the one person who was always there for Cameron. And he was the one who taught Cameron to have fun, which enabled Cameron to finally take a stand against his dad and finally stand up for himself. Ferris even said it himself in the beginning of the film.
Why can't you let me rot in peace?
Cameron, this is my 9th sick day. If I get caught, I won't graduate. I'm not doing this for me, I'm doing it for you.
I've heard some people say that they dislike Ferris because he's a pompous and bratty jackass. And all that's true to some degree. One thing we can all agree on is that Ferris loves his friends, and is doing all this for Cameron. I see a lot of myself in Cameron, and seeing him finally stick up for himself is immensely satisfying and really resonates with me. We all need a Ferris Bueller in our life. Someone to pick us up while we're down. Someone to tell us that everything's gonna be fine. Okay, now that we got the analytical aspect of this video out of the way, we can talk about how much fun this movie is. John Hughes is the king of bringing out our inner child and having us all embrace it. This is one of the most fun movies ever made, with the pure intent of just making you smile and laugh. Ferris basically grabs you by your hand and takes you on the best day of your life. All of the characters in this movie are so vibrant and feel like real people. We've all had a suppressive authority figure like Ed Rooney in our life. Someone who just wants to ruin your fun and put you down, and nothing is more satisfying than seeing the man getting attacked by a guard dog and getting kicked in the face 3 times. All the characters in this movie are fun, even if a few of them don't have any character. Yeah, I know, Sloan doesn't really have a character, but the movie wouldn't be the same without her. Plus, I used to have a huge crush on Mia Sara as a kid, so I'll let that one slide. Jeannie is one of my favorite characters of all time. I absolutely love the love-hate dynamic that she and Ferris have. She hates him enough to want to bust him, but loves him enough to have his back and get him out of any real trouble. Even the two dudes from the garage, the French waiter, and Grace add so much personality and character to this movie. But nothing brings me more joy than watching the parade scene. That scene looks like it was so much fun to film and be a part of. If I had a time machine, I would 100% go back in time to the day that this was shot and dance along with Ferris in the action. Just look how fucking fun this is! Ferris Bueller's Day Off is the anthem for all teenagers and high schoolers, and to say that it had an impact on my life is an understatement. Hell, I used the iconic line from this movie as my senior quote. You cannot deny the cultural impact this movie has had. I see references to this movie everywhere, from Spider-Man to Deadpool to even Family Guy, for Christ's sake. Of course, I think there are movies better made than Ferris Bueller's Day Off, but I've never watched a movie that I've connected with more in my life the same way I did with this one. This movie taught me a lot about living life to the fullest and not to waste my day by doing things I don't want to do. It taught me to stand up for myself and to take a stand when I need to, and to have fun and just enjoy life. I think Ben Stein, the actor who played the economics teacher, said it best in this quote. It will never die, because it responds to and calls forth such human emotions. It isn't dirty, There's nothing mean-spirited about it. There's nothing sneering or sniggering about it. It's just wholesome. We want to be free. We want to have a good time. We know that we're not going to be able to all our lives. We know that we're going to have to buckle down and work. We know that we're going to eventually have to become family men and women and have responsibilities and pay our bills. But just give us a couple of good days that we can all look back on.